It's a mystery condition known as breast implant illness. Increasing numbers of women who claim their implants are making them seriously ill just by being in their bodies. The symptoms are wide and varied, but with no formal recognition by the medical profession, it's easy to dismiss sufferers. Are the problems in their chests or in their heads? Tonight we meet two women who say they've been to hell and back. When I was just a little girl, I asked my mother. It's the day so many brides look forward to.
So what are we looking for?
I honestly am not too sure. I think with my body changing shape so drastically, I want to try on a few different styles today.
Yeah, see what works with your new shape.
Yeah.
Finding the perfect dress.
Try on everything.
But for Sarah Harris, this moment is extra special.
I have a pretty good idea of what I wanted.
Yeah.
But now I've gone down 3 cup sizes. I'm not really sure. This one, for sure.
Just 4 weeks earlier, Sarah had her breast implants removed. An explant.
I can't wait to see you getting some dresses on.
I'm nervous.
I think everyone tries to chase this idea of femininity being bigger boobs, but I felt more feminine trying on wedding dresses with my natural boobs.
It was fun trying on the dresses, wasn't it?
It was. You're a great honorary bridesmaid.
Oh, you look amazing.
Today, Sarah's taking a pain-free walk with fiancé Josh Williams.
Oh, it's so good to have you out and about, finally.
I know. My hips aren't actually sore at all.
Usually we leave the house and go to the end of the road and I would just cry and walk home because I was just in so much pain.
So how bad did things get for you?
Quite bad towards the end there, very, very bad. Honestly, like, some days I just didn't want to be here anymore.
To understand just what that meant, here's what was on the line. 29-year-old Kiwi Sarah Harris is a big name, an international glamour model, regularly followed by the UK tabloids. It all began 10 years ago on a holiday to the US.
I randomly ran into the editor of Maxim Australia. I got home and a couple of days later, I flew to Sydney, shot for the cover of Maxim. And I was just like, wow, oh, this is where I'm meant to be.
She became a guest girl and a Playboy playmate.
So why glamour modelling?
Ironically, because of my implants. You're feeling almost pressured to be a stick with boobs.
Yeah.
With the implants, it put me into the glamour.
She's built a following of 2.3 million on Instagram alone.
If I was behind the camera, I was so confident, but if I was on the other side, I was a very, very shy person.
Do you still feel shy?
Not really. Like, I was a girl that grew up on a farm and my friends were cattle and sheep, you know, so.
The Whanganui farm girl was just 20 when she got her breast implants.
I didn't notice any problems initially.
When did you start noticing problems?
Probably about 4 years ago.
Sarah shared this photo of the endless symptoms with her followers.
The fatigue's a really, really big one. The swelling, the nausea, the food allergies, the random rashes, anxiety and panic attacks, and joint pain.
They were inexplicable and crippling.
I was really losing myself and I just had no will to live anymore. I just, some days it would get really, really bad. But then other days I'd be totally fine.
You felt helpless, you know, you felt like there was so much you wanted to do, but you couldn't. There's a whole bunch, we've got a lot.
Can she take a bad photo?
Fiancé Josh has been with Sarah through it all.
There was some dark days. The anxiety was really, really bad. She was getting like massive allergic reactions as well. We've taken her to the A&E a couple of times. It was quite scary. Look out that way.
It affected him a lot as well. When he first met me, I was a very active person with all this energy and stuff, and then that was kind of just taken from us.
Yeah, that's nice.
But every lead they followed hit a dead end.
Just kept being told it was, you know, IBS, then PCOS, then I changed doctors and they thought I had lymphoma for a while. Then it was lupus. But like, nothing added up. And why would you think that ever had anything to do with implants, you know?
Sarah even had hip surgery for her joint pain. And with another three surgeries lined up, a friend added her to a breast implant illness group with thousands of members.
Because at that point, like, I obviously had no idea if taking my implants out was going to help. I honestly didn't believe it would. I was just reading through and it was uncanny how many people had the same issues as me.
But no doctor, it seemed, could pinpoint the problem.
So tell me, what is BII, or breast implant illness?
Breast implant illness is a self-identity term that women use when they have breast implants and they have a constellation of symptoms that they feel are caused by or associated with their breast implants.
Vice President of the New Zealand Association of Plastic Surgeons, Michelle Locke.
Is it real, BII?
It's hard to know whether BII is real or not. At the moment, it's not a medical diagnosis, so we can't prove or disprove the existence of breast implant illness at all.
Michelle Locke doesn't dismiss BII, but in the world of science, without a test...
There are some doctors out there who would consider all of these symptoms to be in a woman's head. And part of the problem, of course, is that the symptoms are very non-specific. Things like fatigue and brain fog, cognitive dysfunction, those kind of things are very hard to clearly assess.
The thing is, more women are reporting BII, but is it those social media groups?
We think that the increased reporting of breast implant illness symptoms is related to the women having an opportunity to connect with other women who have similar symptoms.
So kind of racking each other up?
Well, I wouldn't say racking each other up, but more validating each other.
Give me your reaction to this statement. Breast implant illness is not real.
It is 100% real.
It's all in your mind.
It's not in my mind.
What would you say to somebody who says these things?
Unless you've lived it, you've got no right to comment on it. I would have headaches, sore neck, pain in the middle of my chest, feeling giddy, sore joints, fatigued, gut problems, high blood pressure.
Michelle Garza says her breast implants were killing her.
I kept thinking I'm going to die. There's something, something's just radically gone wrong with me.
And like many others, she says she struggled to be believed.
It made me feel like an absolute failure. I just wanted people to hear my story and just say, everything's going to be okay.
Initially, when she was going through a lot of the symptoms, I too was somebody who was kind of skeptical in a sense of what's going on, I'm not sure.
Husband Robert Garza changed his mind when he read about breast implant illness, or BII.
So I definitely knew that what she was going through was real, that it wasn't just in her head.
What was a bad day like for you?
3 weeks in bed.
So not a bad day.
Bad 3 weeks, yeah. Where I just had a total breakdown. This is my bedroom, which now I absolutely love. Take me back to last year, it wasn't a happy place to be in. Yeah.
What was happening?
57-year-old Michelle is one of an increasing number of women worldwide reporting BII.
Thank goodness that I found out what was causing my ill health.
BII is a collection of over 40 reported symptoms with no accepted medical diagnosis.
This is where I am now.
But when Michelle had her implants removed last December, her symptoms, she says, began resolving.
So I've had things diminish, like obviously the blood pressure, the headaches, the sore neck, the joint pains have gone. I mean, I can train, which is amazing.
Bring them right in, good, nice control.
Michelle's journey began with a massive weight loss in 2010.
And just decided, I want to be healthy, you know?
28 kgs later, Michelle was on stage competing in body sculpting competitions.
Good job, excellent.
But the weight loss left her unhappy with her breasts. She went to a surgeon for implants.
You were delighted?
Yeah, I was happy with it.
Yeah.
And he never ever told me about breast implant illness.
It's really difficult to warn about something that isn't a proven medical problem.
Top plastic surgeon Michelle Locke sympathises with women, but says right now there's just no way to prove BII.
So if you take them out and the woman feels better afterwards, what's your view of that?
We get asked that a lot. The most common explanation is that surgery has a very strong placebo effect.
In fact, Michelle Locke says, research shows the placebo effect of any kind of surgery can have up to a 75% improvement in symptoms. Nothing's changed, just the perception that it has.
I just don't understand how it could be a placebo.
Model Sarah Harris had an explant just 4 weeks earlier.
Still have my implants in the drawer. Probably not the normal thing to do, but I just like these as a reminder of all the crap that they've given me, really.
Her symptoms improved immediately.
I walked past and was like, I hate you guys, and give them a little punch while I was waiting for the coffee to be made.
So I honestly feel like a completely different person, and if it is a placebo, then sure, I just hope it doesn't come back, because, I feel awesome, and it's better than I've felt in a long time.
Let's go through a list of your symptoms
okay.
and see what's gone and what's still here. So hair loss.
Almost gone.
Anxiety.
Completely gone.
Heart palpitations.
Gone.
Nausea.
Gone.
Food intolerance.
Pretty much gone.
IBS.
Gone.
Chest pain.
Gone.
Hormonal imbalance.
Unsure.
Acne.
Better.
Joint pain.
Completely gone.
Migraine.
Gone.
Vertigo.
Gone.
Rashes.
Gone completely.
Fatigue.
Gone.
That's so good. Amazing.
Yeah.
I mean, that's quite a list, isn't it? To...
It was a lot, eh? I felt like I was going crazy.
I felt like I lost myself. And then I would think, and who is this person, you know? Am I mad, you know? Am I going mad? Ativan, which was when I would get chronic...
A battery of meds for a battery of problems.
Oh, my goodness.
And I'm happy to say I'm off all of it.
You're off all of it.
That are now resolving after an explant.
The scar tissue was so mangled in my rib cage and my pectoral muscles that he had to scrape and cauterize. And he said, best way to describe that, barbecue ribs, black on the barbecue. That's how bad it was.
And in a long-awaited validation, Michelle's surgeon listed breast implant illness in her notes. A medical practitioner willing to buck the accepted wisdom, like surgeon Chris Powell.
Is breast implant illness real?
Yeah, I absolutely think breast implant illness is real.
Chris Powell has been researching BII and says he's nearly ready to publish his findings.
Do you feel confident that you can prove its existence?
I think I have evidence that can help to prove its existence.
What have you discovered?
So I basically continue the work that my colleague David Crabb had been doing before me. One of the theories that's out there is that what drives breast implant illness is a subclinical infection, so that these implants or the capsules around them have, to some degree, some bacteria in there that drive a low level of infection, which drives up an immune response.
The capsule is the scar tissue that forms around an implant. When Chris Powell removes the implant, he also removes the capsule, which is then tested for bacteria. The results have him convinced.
In every single capsule, there is evidence of some kind of bacteria there.
It's 100%.
That's what we think at the moment.
So once you have a low-level infection, this can account for hair coming out, brain fog, anxiety, all sorts of different symptoms?
We think that's a theory at the moment. That's a theory. It's not proven, and that's one of the many branches of the investigation into breast implant illness that needs to really be elucidated. What you have here is the outer shell, which is silicon.
What would help, he says, is a breast implant registry.
We're perhaps significantly behind the curve here in New Zealand, where we're not able to monitor that in the same way that they are in other countries, such as the UK has a mandatory breast registry. We should get on board with that and have a breast registry in New Zealand.
So one of the problems with knowing how common breast implant illness is that we have no idea how many women in New Zealand have breast implants.
Vice President for the Plastic Surgeons Association, Michelle Locke, has been lobbying for a breast implant registry for years. Biggest stumbling block?
Money. Biggest stumbling block's always money.
The need for a registry is urgent, says Michelle Locke, to help gauge the prevalence of breast implant issues like BII. But for now...
So when you sit down with a patient and you talk about the risks, do you specifically mention BII at all?
No, I don't.
So why not just say BII is a thing that some people think exists?
Yeah.
You might want to do some research on that.
Yeah, it's probably a fair call.
Do you think you will, going forward?
Yes, probably.
Good girl.
When you look to the future now, how do you feel?
Positive and very optimistic. It's like, yay, the old Michelle is backing. She's arrived.
How much do you regret the implants now?
I don't think I regret it because, despite everything I've been through, if I'd backtracked, I still would have got them. It did help me with my career initially, and it's now helping me help other women not make the same mistakes.
Meanwhile, Sarah's enjoying her new shape with the big day ahead.
Oh my God! Oh, wow.
Not something I would really
regret,
but so pretty. It's like princess vibes.
You're like mother of the bride.
Darling, I love it.
It's really beautiful. So when you think about the future now, how do you feel?
Very excited. Really excited, actually. I'm really grateful to know going into it, Josh is going to be marrying the healthy person he met. So it's really exciting.
Just gorgeous. Now, we don't know if Sarah's going to choose that dress. It was just our favourite on the day. Meanwhile, the government isn't committing to a breast implant registry at this point. For more, go to our Facebook page.